anybody I think who's really reading into comics and want to know stories that always don't end up in the same way, the same guy doesn't have to keep winning and all that, that's where independent comics come in. When people get sick of like the mainstream stuff and they look for like other stuff. So what we're looking at is independent creators having their own ideas, putting down independent stories. So it can go in whichever way. I think as an art form, that's the cool part about comics that I liked also.
I guess the word indie or independent for me is more about a certain approach to making comics where your responsibility is not just to, you know, make wonderful looking pages of graphic form, but also distributing that form, publishing that form. You know, it's your responsibility to find your public. And I think that attitude for me is indie. And that's what we are celebrating in this festival as well.
Independent art also allows for independent thought to come out properly. When you belong in a publishing house or a production house or something, you're always dictated as to what to say. So the artist is always not putting out his own thought, but he's putting out something that is the larger agenda that he has to represent or something. Art that I do should be with this kind of tone, irreverent, you know, everyone should get it. There has to be a humor to it. There has to be satire, sarcasm, original thought.
The general scene here is geared outside the gallery. It has a thriving public art scene and various bodies that are working around public art practice. And for us to really host a comics or hope for a comic scene to take shape here, it's a very easy idea because there are many people here who have been making comics. It's a really strange convergence of sorts where different people who were earlier in different cities are now, you know, part of the same scene. I think that's what makes it extremely very, very exciting, not just for me but for others as well.
Kind of nice to see so many people coming up with their own comics. It's when I saw the Bombay and the Delhi lead up and all that for indie comics that I realized that those many people are actually producing their comics and putting it out.
The idea could be that we take publishing in our own hands and discover ways of bringing comics to people aside of, say, taking it to a larger retail store or something like that, but to make it accessible to everyone. I mean, I don't know who goes and buys comics now unless you're part of a certain hip crowd who reads or talks about comics, and I'm not part of that crowd. But if there was a market which actually sold these leaflets or zines and stuff, I'd be interested in looking at them and seeing what's the thought process going behind the artists, or, you know, I'm more keen in seeing what can be done as opposed to what is indie.
Also, because there are established names here, there are obviously younger artists or first-time artists who are also sort of, you know, trying to make comics. We've tried to have a thriving comic book program for the last year and a half or so. So I think it's more with the hope to convert the comic book reader into the maker that I think the Bangalore chapter holds a lot of potential.
It will be like music now. It will be like the smaller scenes, the smaller collectives and things that come together to like form something. Like indie comics, we're all trying to like put in efforts so that the comic scene stays alive and, more importantly, the artists stay alive.